Forms and Ontraport are how you gather information from people who visit your website. And they're also how you'll sell products, and they're the central tool you need to make Ontraport's visitor tracking work. So, in this Form Basics video, we're going to break down the different components of forms so that you can set them up right every time. Let's get started. And let's start with the big picture. Forms are composed of fields and a submit button. And anytime that submit button is clicked, the data in the fields gets sent to Ontraport, where it's either saved as a new record or added to an existing record. The data from the form ends up in the corresponding fields in your database, as you would probably expect. So, the first name your visitor gives you is put into the first name field in the contact record, and the email address is put in the email field, and so on. At the same time, a bunch of other things can happen in response to a form submission based on your form's settings. So, for example, you'll want the person who filled out the form to be sent to another page, which we call a thank you page. And you may want that visitor, who's now a contact in your account, to be added to a follow-up automation so that you can start sending them a series of emails or text messages. And you may want to notify someone on your team when a form is submitted so that they can follow up. All of this and more can be set up using your form settings. But in Ontraport, forms do a lot more than simply collect information and kick off automations. They're also at the heart of Ontraport's contact tracking features, which are super powerful and can help you understand what's getting you more customers and what's not. You'll be able to see where each contact came from, every page they visited, what they clicked on, and more. But you've got to use Ontraport forms to make that magic happen. For now, there are three main things we want you to know about forms in Ontraport. The different kinds of forms you can set up, how merging contacts works, and what the form settings are for, and we're going to cover these right now. In Ontraport, there are a few different ways that you can show forms to your visitors. A form might be embedded in a page like this, or it might pop up when somebody clicks a button like this, and sometimes you might want to get a form that pops up when people first visit a site or when they're about to leave, while other times you might want a form that sticks to the top of a page. You might want to collect all the information in one go like this, and other times it makes sense to split the form up into multiple steps. All of this is possible in Ontraport, and you'll learn all about how to set things up in the coming videos. Be sure to watch the next one on when to use each form builder so you're always using the right tool for the job. Now let's switch gears to talk briefly about how merging contacts works. One of the most frustrating things about using a CRM is ending up with multiple copies of the same person in your database. That can lead to all sorts of issues and confusion, so let's go over how Ontraport identifies contacts and merges their records using forms. We actually created a whole video called Updating Existing Records Using Forms because there are a lot of fancy tricks that you can use to make this super slick, but for now, just understand this. When someone fills out a form using an email address that already exists in your database, we'll figure out that that's the same person and we'll merge the existing record with the new information from the form. But if someone comes around and uses a different email address the second time, now we have a problem, because now Ontraport's going to make a new record for them instead of updating the old one. And since everyone has a bunch of different email addresses these days, it can happen all the time. So, fortunately, we have a really good way to avoid this problem. And that's exactly what you're going to learn in the video called Updating Existing Records Using Forms later on in this course. So be sure to check that out. The last thing for now is form settings, because no matter which of our form editors you end up using, the settings are all pretty much the same. So let's dive in. You'll find different form settings in different places depending on the editor that you end up using, and we've got a video for each editor that'll walk you through that part. But once you get to the settings, here's what you're going to find. First is opt-in settings, which controls whether a contact is single or double opted in. And this can help you guarantee that the contact information that you're getting is genuine. Next, you'll have send contacts here, which controls that thank you page we were talking about after they click the submit button. Conditional redirects is a special tool that will let you send people to different pages depending on what they said in your form. So for example, let's say you're an auto shop that offers deals on basic car maintenance, and somebody fills out your form saying that they're looking for an oil change. You can use this feature to send them to a page about the benefits of an oil change from your shop. Similarly, if they said they wanted their brakes checked, you can send them to a different page that tells you all about your experience stopping cars. Below that is the Manage Form Fills. And this is where you can add contacts who fill out this form to automations. Next, under Notifications and Routing, you can send a notification to someone when the form is filled out, and you can also decide who will be the contact owner for that particular record. Advanced features are for very specific use cases, which are all explained in other videos. Last, we have hidden fields, which, well, they're fields that are hidden on your form. This is usually used for capturing data that's going to be passed through the URL rather than submitted by the contact themselves. But don't worry about that right now, we're going to cover it later. And that wraps up our form basics overview. In the rest of this section, we're going to take a tour of each of the form types and how to style and configure them. And we'll also dive into the forms on Ontraport pages, Ontraport forms, and legacy forms. And we're going to also address some specific uses for our form tools such as multi-step forms and multi-object forms. And finally, we'll tackle some of the more complex features in a series of deep dives. Now that you have a good handle on how forms work in general, you're ready to learn about when to use each specific form type. We'll see you there.